Tonight, a new expert has joined the investigation. KCRA3's Richard Sharp is live in Tracy at a still-growing memorial at Sandra's mobile home park. Richard?
And Edie, some late-breaking news with that memorial. Just over my shoulder, just about 5 minutes ago, you can see those two trucks that just got here. Those are city trucks. City workers just arrived on scene to start removing this entire memorial. Keep in mind, it has grown to more than 50 feet long, and they're not just teddy bears and balloons there. They're also more personal items, like, for example, Hello Kitty balloons and stickers. And if you remember, Sandra Cantu was wearing a Hello Kitty t-shirt when she disappeared. A handwritten poster shows the growing fear of a community still trying to cope with Sandra's death. Just down the street, a sea of teddy bears, bunnies, and dogs only grows.
We're all sad that this happened. Bring my kids and explain to them what happened.
Families like this one have come here from Stockton to see the memorial and show their children.
I think it's sad because she hasn't been spent much of her life.
How important is it for your family to see this?
It's very important for them to see, you know, as far as what happened to this little girl.
Tonight, all of this will be removed at the request of the family.
We're planning to take the teddy bears and all of the stuffed animals and donating them to children's hospitals and to the police department and fire department when they have to deal with little kids, because we know that that's what Sandra would have wanted.
Meanwhile, the search for Sandra's killer continues. Police are now working with an FBI profiler to gain insight into the killer's behavior. And tonight, Pastor Lane Lawless returned to the Clover Road Baptist Church just a day after it was searched by the FBI. He wouldn't talk on camera, but said his congregation is meeting tonight just like they do every week, but in an undisclosed location because of all the attention. Back at the memorial, a common theme is starting to show here. In all the personal messages, people are now referring to Sandra as Tracy's little angel.
This is like a wake-up call to me.
So once again, Sandra Cantu's family has requested that this entire memorial be taken down, and mostly because it is supposed to rain tonight here in Tracy, and they want to get all the teddy bears, all the toys off of the lawn so they're not ruined by the rain, so they can donate them. Also, the family has asked for volunteers throughout the city to take down all those missing posters that have Sandra Cantu's face on them, to start doing that tomorrow, because it's just a reminder of something that they're trying to deal with and cope at this hour. Live in Tracy, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 reports.
We also heard some strong emotion today from Sandra's uncle and grandfather, who spoke for the first time since her body was found.
It's just sad that somebody would think so despicable to kill this little girl. I mean, that's crazy. It's insane. It's a monster out there.
It's ridiculous. Absurd, and it's gross, grotesque.
You want this guy.
Oh, I want him bad.
Sandra's mother, seen here climbing these stairs in a white t-shirt today, did not want to speak with the media. She and Sandra's grandmother both went to the hospital to be sedated the night Sandra's body was identified.